What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool transfer news video. And in this video we will talk about the reports coming from the Marca newspaper that Liverpool have made an offer to sign Memphis Depay, who is a free agent in the summer, so Liverpool could sign him on a free transfer. And he has been in blistering form, having scored 15 goals and got 9 assists in just 31 games for Lyon. So that is for 31 games, 24 goals plus assists combined, which is a really, really terrific goal return that he was involved in, 24 goals. Let me know in the comments below, do you think Memphis Depay would be a great signing for Liverpool? On a free transfer, I think 27-year-old Dutch international, friends with Virgil van Dijk, friends with Gini Wijnaldum, it's a no-brainer for Liverpool to make an offer for him. But not only Liverpool are interested, but Barcelona and Juventus. And guys, if you enjoyed these transfer news updates, leave a like, subscribe, turn on the bell notifications so you never miss the latest Liverpool transfer news update. And he has been in pretty stunning form for Lyon, who are fighting for the title in the French league. Recently Paris Saint-Germain lost at home to Lille, so now Lille are first, PSG are second, and Monaco are third. Lyon are fourth after just drawing recently their game. And Depay is keen to move on after when his contract expires at Lyon. He thinks he is better than playing in the French league for a club like Lyon. He can do so much more. And Barcelona are also interested in Memphis Depay because they are not really cash rich nowadays. They have big financial problems, so they will try to sign as many free agents as possible. And in my opinion, Depay would be a wonderful signing on a free transfer. And even 12 or 18 months ago, you would think that Depay would never sign for Liverpool because he wouldn't want to sit on the bench. But this season, because Mane and Firmino have been in pretty awful goal scoring form, I think Depay would be in and around the first team definitely from next season. And he is also younger than Liverpool's current front three, and he still has a good 5 years at the top, so signing him on a 5-year contract would make a brilliant sense. It's basically a no-brainer transfer, even though Memphis Depay used to play for Manchester United. He only had one season there really, and I think he would have a really, really great motivation to come back to the Premier League and to show everyone that he was better than what he showed at Manchester United, because he only scored 7 goals in all competitions in 45 games. But since he signed for Lyon, he scored 69 goals in 169 appearances, and on average he scores about 15 goals per season. In his first really full season, where he played most of the games, he scored 22 goals, then 12, then 15, and this 15 goals in just 22 games in last season, which was cut short. The French league never restarted, they just cut the league and that's it. And he scored 15 goals in 22 games last season. This season he has 15 goals in 31 games and also 9 assists, so I think his goals to games ratio is really, really terrific. And also he's a regular goal scorer for the Netherlands as well. He's got 23 goals in just 62 games for the Netherlands. And what is also staggering is that if you add up Depay's goals and assists, he amassed 121 goal contributions in just 169 games. So he's involved in either a goal or an assist every 2 games out of 3, which is absolutely brilliant in my opinion. And as I said, Depay is worth around 30-40 million pounds in today's market, so to have him signed on a free transfer is an absolute no-brainer. It's an absolute bargain. It only depends where Depay we want to go, because it looks like Barcelona, Liverpool and Juventus are all interested in Memphis Depay's services. And Memphis Depay is, in my opinion, almost as good as Bobby Firmino, and he's definitely much better than Origi, much better than Shadra Shaqiri, and this would just add to the already very, very good attacking options for Liverpool. And I don't want Liverpool to sell any of the current front three. Diogo Jota is here to stay, and I want Salah, Mane and Firmino also to stay. But Memphis Depay would add something different, a great new addition a great player who can play in various positions. He can play as a front striker, he can play behind the striker, as a false nine, as a center forward, even as an attacking midfielder, and he can even play out wide. He played out wide quite a few times for Liverpool, for the Netherlands and for Lyon, sorry. And if you think about 121 goals and assists in just 169 games, I think we can safely say Manchester United made a massive error selling Memphis Depay after just one season. They really should have stuck with him and gave him more opportunities, but what's Man United's loss could be Liverpool's gain. And also, what is also even more surprising is that I'm just reading that Man United had a buyback clause on Memphis Depay, so they could have bought him back at any moment during his Lyon career, but they haven't activated his buyback clause. And it's considering Man United have struggled with the number 9, Martial has been pretty iffy, his form has been in and out, Cavani is also has been injured quite a few times. So they didn't have a consistent goal scorer like Memphis Depay, Manchester United, this season or even last season. So for them to not buy back Memphis Depay during his Lyon contract is pretty surprising. And right now, after his contract expires, there is no buyback clause anymore for Manchester United, so the Memphis Depay can sign with anyone he wants, really. And Diogo Jota actually commented on the top 4 race. He said that this win against Arsenal was very important. I think about higher spots in the table. We need to do our job, which is to win every single game until the end of the season. And if we do that, then I think we have a chance to be there in the top 4. I think if we do our job, we have a great chance, because it is very hard to win in the Premier League. And today, we did our job, we beat Arsenal, and let's go to the next one. And I absolutely love that everybody is slating Gareth Southgate after Trent Alexander-Arnold's brilliant performance and great cross for the Diogo Jota goal. And England's best right back, that's what James Pearce has called Trent Alexander-Arnold. And even Jurgen Klopp said that Trent's assist for Jota's opening goal is outstanding. Look, when you play a game like Trent played against Arsenal, when you are fully in the game without thinking a lot, focusing on the important stuff in the game, then you can do these kind of things. In a worse game, even Trent doesn't cross like that, but tonight he had an exceptionally good game. And yes, the cross was really well taken, but the header, Jota still had to finish it off. It's not as easy as it looks, but Diogo did that, and that's very important. It was a very important statement for Liverpool, because we need to show that we fight for the top 4. We cannot only talk about it, we have to show it on the pitch, and we did that, especially with the way we defended against Arsenal. If we defend like we did against Arsenal, then we are a difficult team to break down. And if we are too difficult to break down, we have a good basis then to play football and get great results. And that's what we did. And that's why it was so important. In our situation, it's clear, with all the things that happened to us in the past this season, they brought us in a position where we don't have it in our own hands, the top 4. We have to win our games, and somebody else has to lose or drop points, because we don't play most of them above us anymore. But we have to make pressure on them, and that's what we did tonight with the result. We are still not in the end of the season or finished. Everton still can pass us, West Ham can pass us, and all these kind of things. So we have to fight, and that's the statement for us and nobody else. And Trent didn't have a lot of rest, because we trained quite intensely with the boys that we had. But yes, for sure, the things we did in training helped him. When you play 3 games in 10 days, there is not a lot of time for training, because you recover, and then you already have to play the next game. We had time to train, to work on things, and that helps. I can understand why it's a story, and I said the things I think I had to say, because it's my opinion, but I don't want to get it misunderstood. I'm not criticizing Gareth Southgate or whatever. I don't want people to think I have an argument with Gareth. I don't have, not at all. I respect his role and his decision, but I know the player better than anyone else, than any other coach, and I can say that Trent is a world-class player, not only offensively. Does he perform always world-class? No. But I don't know a player who is doing that. It's Trent's potential, that's it. And since Fabinho has been back as a defensive midfielder, Liverpool kept 3 clean sheets in a row, and it's really good, Klopp said. It all helps. But we have a lot of games, and we will see if they can play all the games. If not,
We will have to make changes. It is 3 clean sheets in a row, which is great. The whole team defended on a different level than before. I have to say it's not the only the two in the center, the center backs. It was a really good defensive performance overall, and that was necessary. That's what you need. That's what we did. And let's hope that we all stay fit for the best part of the season, in the final part of the season. And Jurgen Klopp also said that this is like a mini season for Liverpool. These rest few games, because now that we have we had a 3-week break, it's like a mini season for Liverpool, where Liverpool have to squeeze everything out of this mini season to get the best possible situation out of this season still. And I mean, we are still in the race for the top four, and on current form, Liverpool have actually a good chance of making the top four, because the teams above us are faltering. Tottenham couldn't win against Newcastle, Chelsea even lost at home to West Brom 5-2, which is absolutely shocking, and also Everton, Aston Villa, West Ham are all pretty inconsistent. So if Liverpool can consistently win games throughout the season, the last 8 games are all winnable, then we can definitely finish in the top 4. And also we have the Champions League coming up, Real Madrid on Tuesday. I can't wait. It's tomorrow. It's really, really exciting. I can't wait for it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Have a nice day. See you later. Goodbye.